There are a number of complaints coming in about the new Godzilla Secret Lairs that just got shipped out to people. And on top of that, Wizards has made a hilarious mistake with Jumpstart. Greetings, owners of fine luxury cardboard rectangles. I hope you enjoyed the lore video that I released earlier today. It is fantastic. We're right in the midst of the Karn story. So if you haven't checked it out, go get you some. Go get you some Karn goodness. But wait until we're done here, especially for the fun part at the end of the video. Because first, what we're going to do is we're going to talk about Secret Lair, and then we're going to talk about some Jumpstart silliness. Because we've done other videos just getting right into Jumpstart or whatever. We're just going to have a chuckle at the end. So, starting out with the Godzilla Secret Lairs, what's going down? They have been shipped out to everybody, and there are a couple of complaints that people have. One of the complaints is that the cards themselves are coming all warped, curved. I mean, is this really a big surprise? Card quality has essentially at one of its all-time lows, and I believe those lands are foil as well, are they? I'm pretty sure they're foil. So if they're foil, that adds to the warping level, right? So you have a scenario where people are dissatisfied with the quality, and let's be fair, that's perfectly understandable. To go ahead and pay a premium price for a premium object, let's not mistake it, that's what this is. They're selling 5 basic lands, right? And basic lands are normally, in most cases, one of the most worthless things in Magic the Gathering, with certain exceptions. Obviously, unlands are worth a lot of money, guru lands, basically lands that are scarce, as in hard to find, and are visually attractive, tend to do pretty well value-wise, but the majority of basic lands are worthless, right? So the idea behind this is they're going to sell you 5 basic lands with Godzilla on them. Now, obviously, one of the complaints people have about the Secret Lair, which is kind of a fair complaint, is that Wizards knows, like, if you build a deck, you're probably going to care about having more than one copy of a particular land. So I'm hearing from people who have ordered 5 of these Secret Lairs, 10 of these Secret Lairs, right? We're dealing with a Secret Lair where multiple iterations are more attractive than just one. And by that, I mean previous Secret Lairs, like, what was the one? It was Serum Visions. They have 4 different versions of Serum Visions, so 4 different artworks. But when you buy the Secret Lair, you're getting a playset of Serum Visions, all you need for one deck. Now, when it comes to basic lands, I personally don't know anybody who only plays decks where they use one of each basic land. You know what I mean? So if you're playing green-blue, you're going to want like a dozen of these Godzilla forests and a dozen of these Godzilla islands to be able to fill out your deck. So some people are dissatisfied about that aspect of it, but that has nothing to do with the fact that when you buy these, and in this case, lots of these, they come out all warped and unusable, essentially. That's what it turns into, because you can't use these cards that all, like, that are bent in any sort of official tournament capacity because they're considered marked cards. This is one of the absurdities that comes along with Magic the Gathering, is that the most premium edition they make of cards, which is foil, right? The most premium edition they make of cards makes them unusable in official tournament play. Like, doesn't that sound insane? So you already have the fact that, like, you've got these premium editions, but then you've got Godzilla box, which takes it even further, where you pay $30 American for 5 lands, and then they come out all messed up. And you just go, what am I paying for? Like, if you're gonna sell 5 cards at a premium price, they should be premium quality. Do you know what I mean? Like, Wizards of the Coast has a number of different locations that they can manufacture cards at. And we know this, we've seen the results. Depending on whether they pick like a North American, a Belgian, a Japanese printer, whatever it is, they all have different standards of quality and they produce different results. And in my opinion, the current best place to get results from is from Japanese print shops. So these could have been printed using the highest quality printers, but unfortunately, Wizards is always looking to cut costs where they can, and maybe internally they argued that, you know what, really it's just a collector's item, and people will just, like, Godzilla collectors will want it, which is part of the customer base. And I will say, in terms of the Godzilla being in Magic the Gathering, I prefer Secret Lairs to what they did inside of Ikoria. And I mean that they basically forced us to accept Godzilla as like actual Magic cards, because the BioBox promo was Godzilla, but there was no regular version. Like every other Godzilla card they put in Ikoria has a normal version. So you have Godzilla and you have Yodaro, and they're the exact same card. So if you don't care about Godzilla, you can just go check it out. I'm playing with Yodaro. But with the BioBox promo, you don't get that option, right? It's just legit, okay, you're going to play with Godzilla. That's how it goes. And I don't like that. I feel like Godzilla being put into like a regular Magic set feels weird, but I feel like a Secret Lair is the perfect place to do it. You get to experiment. It has nothing to do with what the canon of a set is. You know what I mean? Like, it's kind of like, well, now Godzilla's a part of the Magic the Gathering universe because there's no equivalent for the BioBox guy. And that doesn't feel normal. Like, that doesn't feel right for Magic the Gathering. Now, I know that this is just my opinion, right? I know there are definitely people who disagree with me about that. However, the Godzilla Secret Lair is a great way. Like, they can do whatever kind of crazy Secret Lairs they want. You want to do like a Garfield Secret Lair where Garfield is eating a mountain of lasagna and that's your mountain? Knock yourself out if it's a Secret Lair. So I'm on board with that. Now, the other complaint that people had about the Secret Lair, specifically the Godzilla one, is that the foil stained glass walker in the box is the same one for each Secret Lair. So previously with Secret Lairs, when we got the whole batch of like the original release of Secret Lairs, Wizards cunningly included stained glass planeswalkers, which I thought was a really nice move on their part. It's just an added bonus that wasn't advertised. They didn't use it to lure you in. It's just a nice extra reward for the consumer. I really liked that. I really enjoyed the fact that they brought the stained glass walkers into Paper Magic, because I'm going to be real, I love stained glass. I think it's really, really cool. Those ancient like church windows and things like that are amazing to me, blow my mind. So the stained glass walkers, most of them did the same thing. Jaya Ballard's got a really weird face in the stained glass walker setting, but either way, I really like the stained glass walkers. So they included them like randomly. You would get different random ones in certain Secret Lairs, and other Secret Lairs had preset planeswalkers, but the preset planeswalkers were applicable to the Secret Lair. So what's happened with the Godzilla Secret Lair is every single one that's been reported has come with a foil Nissa planeswalker, right? So no matter, like, if you ordered 5 of these, 10 of these, you're getting stuck with the exact same card 10 times over. But the problem is Nissa has nothing to do with Godzilla. When they did the Oh My God Cat Secret Lair, they put a Johnny as the automatic planeswalker to go with it. And that makes perfect sense. It's a cat-themed box set and a cat-themed planeswalker. It fits perfectly. There was another one, I can't remember which other one seemed to have a static planeswalker set to it, but it didn't stand out the same. Like, there's no connection between Nissa and the Godzilla Secret Lair, so they should have been randomized planeswalkers, because how does Wizards not know that there are going to be people who go, you know what, I want a bunch of these Godzilla lands. I want to actually be able to play with these. I mean, they allow you to order up to 10 or 15 of these, so this should be something where it should have been randomized, and that is a failure to, basically what it does is it diminishes that extra step that they're taking, where it's like, yes, you included the extra walker, but you're also flooding these out and sticking people with like 10 copies of it. What are you supposed to do with 10 copies of Nissa? So those are the complaints going around about Godzilla Secret Lair. I also wanted to talk about something really funny with the actual Jumpstart booster boxes. Okay, so basically, you know how Jumpstart has all these different themes, you know, like lightning and dogs and cats and vampires and rogues, all that sort of thing. Well, the next time you are looking at a Jumpstart booster box, be it in the LGS or if you have one at home, pause the video, go grab it right now, because you're in for a little chuckle. This is just some lighthearted silliness. So you take the box and you turn it around to the back of the box where it has the description, okay? Now you can ignore the description because what you're actually looking for is just the text that's stamped in like kind of half faded white lettering. It's just background decoration. And you'll notice when you look at it all that it has all the names of all the different themes, right? Which is, it's cool, you know, it's a nice design choice, but here's the thing. They didn't really run it through the spell checker, so instead of having the lightning theme, they have a lighting theme, which is leading a bunch of people to make jokes about actually making the theme pack themselves using things like torches, chromatic lantern. You know, like there are literally cards where you could make a lighting theme pack, but it's just hilarious that on the official, it's like all these excited concepts, get your vampires, get your dragons, and then it's like, don't forget lighting. We've got a nice, you know, we're gonna do the wiring in your home theme pack. I found that pretty amusing, and I thought it'd be nice to end off on a fun little note. Now, if you haven't watched my lore video from earlier today, definitely go and check it out, my friends. It is fantastic. The story is getting really good. Thanks for coming by, everybody. If you like what I'm doing, like, comment, subscribe, share the video around. Really great for the channel. Appreciate all the support. I will see you all, my friends, very soon. But for now, bye!